بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد، اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليه. My dear sister, my dear brother, my dear viewer, my dear listener, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Allow me first to remind you of two things before I go into my subject and my talk, as I will be doing inshallah every week, every Monday at 3 o'clock London time here. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever fast Ramadan, follow fasting 6 days in Shawwal, it will be considered like fasting the whole year. A big offer. Remember that. And half of Shawwal has gone. We still have got about half of the month of Shawwal. We are in it now, in the middle of it. So please, my dear brother and sister, do not forget to fast 6 days in Shawwal, because it will be counted like you are fasting the whole year instead of just 1 month Ramadan only. This is the first, very important, a big offer. You can fast separately, you can fight 6 days together, etc. My second point, please, please, whoever who is able to go to Hajj, do not delay, do not postpone. You never know. It could be your last month, my last month in this life. Whoever can do Hajj, do it. Able to go, travel, it's a harsh journey, although we have got 5-star hotel, etc., etc., still a harsh journey, you know, there, doing manasik al-hajj. So please, Hajj is coming soon, Eid Adha coming soon, so please do it, one, the fifth pillar of Islam. Many Muslims, they don't know. They die suddenly, heart attack, cancer, or accident, or disaster. And they have been saying, we'll do Hajj later. And they lost. So please, make effort to do that. Now, coming back to my subject, inshallah, each week, hopefully, the general title of my weekly talk or show, Islam and current issues. Current issue, medical, health, social, scientific, ethical, religious, issue which are published in medical journal, in daily newspaper, TV, radio, magazine, etc. Alhamdulillah, I have the ability and the skill to read a lot and to catch what's relevant to Islam, to Muslim, and what is good for health education. I'll try to mention, I try to raise action, and today I have 2 actions for you. You British Muslim, apply to Muslim living in Britain, British Muslim. And I bring a lot of new, if you call it tafaseer, barahin, ayat, evidence to many things in Islam. Halal for your health, haram for your disease and suffering, etc. Sometimes I like to call my series of weekly talk or show this ayah, beautiful ayah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, talking about the future. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سنريهم آياتنا في الآفاق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق. In the Quran, more than 1400 years ago, Allah said, we shall, future, we are the future, and we still have more future coming. More than 1400 years ago, Allah said in the Quran, we shall show them our sign, our evidence, our barahin, in the horizon, star, moon, Apollo, going and seeing the balance, beautiful creation, planet, star, etc. And Allah said, we'll show our sign in themselves. Themselves mean me and you, our body, our biology, our psychology, our anatomy, our physiology, our pathology, our social study, psychological study. Allah said, is happening all the time. Hardly, wallahi, hardly pass a day without finding some new evidence. Frequently, especially in medical and social study. Evidence that this Islam is right, this Quran is a true holy book, and Islam is truly the final religion to mankind. And that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, final prophet. Remember that, because some quack called so-called Muslim making a new man, new prophet after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Final prophet. So you're going to see, inshallah, a lot of interesting topic and subject variety. I'm sure everyone would like enjoy the test of some of these, if not many or most of it, you know. And we'll try to discuss different topic, what happened the last few days in the British media, in the medical media, and regarding issue problem affecting Muslim in Britain. I'm living in London, Britain. I deal with the issue of Muslim in Britain. Now, I have to mention one thing important. After maybe 40 minutes, 45 minutes, we'll have time for the question and comment. I want you to be aware of that. Question and comment. English or Arabic? I know both. Alhamdulillah. But anyone talking to me, please. I always say it. I have difficulty to understand the Somali accent. You have to speak slowly, good English or good Arabic. Arabic, Fusha, strict Arabic, Quranic Arabic, not twisted Arabic, Somali, twisted, my country, Lebanese Arabic. You know, you have to speak clearly and slowly, inshallah. You got question, you ask. At the end of the program, you got comment, you ask. You mention it. You got correction, correct me. I'm a human being like everybody else. Last week, I mentioned general introduction about my interest, my topic, my activity. And today, I pick up for you many interesting topics. So people, inshallah, will not get bored, you know, and variety. Some people love this subject, some people love the other subject, etc. And all my whole intention is to show you all the time the greatness of Islam. Or maybe you will get it. You will deduct it yourself. You don't need me to tell you. Showing greatness, how Islam is a great religion for your health, for your happiness, for your environment, for your society, for animal, for non-Muslim, for everything in life. And what I will bring to you all the time, statistic, study, social study, medical study, etc., etc., written by non-Muslim, not Muslim. This is the beauty about it, living here in the heart of the West, in London, in Britain, United Kingdom, one can see and get a lot of material. So easy, so handy. And as you know, the website, internet, Google search, it gives you a lot of material. You can use it. So hopefully, inshallah, you will find with me, gradually we're raising day after day the flag of Islam. The flag of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final prophet to mankind. You will find it all the time. Before I start, please get your pen or pencil.
small paper, because two action I touch on one last week. I want you to be aware of these two action for the British Muslim, for Muslim living in Britain. 2 minute job, email, small letter. This part of my interest to make Muslim active, as they say, British citizen, like the English. They know how to contact, how to complain, what to do, etc., etc. It's very important, because still, by and large, I have been like 40 years in Britain. I came from Lebanon, and qualified medical doctor from Cairo University when I came here, you know, and I still see Muslim by and large isolated. They don't interact with society problem. They don't speak their vote. They don't speak up. They don't express their opinion. They keep it to themselves inside the mosque. This is wrong. If you are living here, almost all of them, dying here, marrying, having marriage here, buying house, settling down here, you have to be British citizen. Muslim and British citizen, in order to show the beauty, the gold, they're still hidden in the mosque, the beauty and the gold of Islam. Non-Muslim are lost by and large. They don't know. And Islam is so distorted in the media, very bad image, terrorist, cruel to animal, oppress woman, suppress woman, uneducated, primitive, etc., etc., etc. We need to come out to speak up, to explain our beautiful religion in an English relevant way. You have to be aware of the intelligence of the English people, how they think, how they act, how they understand, etc. So part of what I'm talking, I'm sure some of you will find it very useful for da'wah, inshallah, and a good material, very useful. Hopefully this program will be repeated one evening during the week, because I expect most of you watching now are women, which is good, but I want also the men who are working or in college or university, I want them also to see this program, inshallah. Hopefully will be repeated in one evening at night. Now, two action and about 15 new study, discovery, raising the flag of Islam. I don't think we'll have time to go through them all, you know. But let me say the action, because we got only 3 days left to one of them, the other one, 1 week left. What's the first one, which I touched on it last week, as you might remember? We're having a big problem today, and not only in Britain, in Europe, in the West, and in our Muslim country, Arabic country. As I mentioned to you before, computer, children watching haram, sexy stuff, pornography, they say, porn. It's open. Website, internet. And we have serious case in Britain now. And I'm grateful to my Christian friend. They are taking the lead. I don't know where are the Muslims. They say we want to protect our children. So those who give us internet, Virgin, BT, Sky, TalkTalk, they should block. Not seen by children. They should block all the sexual film, pornography, video, etc., which full of haram, muharamat, about 20 muharamat related, forgive me in using this term, related to sex and adultery and fornication and incest and unbelievable. Our Christian parents wake up here in Britain. They're making campaign, many websites, and now they collected 110,000 petition, signature. They're going to meet Prime Minister now, soon. All what we're asking, block the sexual film from the internet. We don't want our children at home sitting at night
in their bedroom on the computer watching haram stuff. It destroys their morality. It destroys their soul. It makes them addicted. They wouldn't be able to concentrate and study, and they get involved in zina, adultery. A big list. I don't want to mention it now. Block. Anybody over 18 years old, please. You are allowed. Between you and me, we should not allow it to the adult and children. But here, at least you have to say the adult responsible. Over 18, they can contact Virgin, BT, TalkTalk, any internet provider. Open for me the sexual film. It will come on the website, on the internet, in his computer. So we're not stopping everything. We are worried about the children. So finally, for this subject, block porn online. To the children, not only children. We're discovering a lot of casualty adult. And some Muslim boy, some Muslim man married, is destroying marriage and make person, Muslim man, committing haram, watching the haram stuff on the computer. So block porn, they call it porn or sexual, online. Online mean internet, website, etc., etc. I'm going to give you only one website. Has got all detail. Who to write to. There is consultation. Consultation means question and answer. You can see it and answer it. In this consultation, only question 10 we want you to answer it as a parent. To ask the internet provider and the government. This is coming from the government, the consultation. Department of Education, to ask them to block the internet for our children. You know, very simple, very easy. Two way. One way, answer the consultation. We have got 3 days left. 6 September, we'll stop, we'll finish the time for it. The other simple, easy way, in this website, I will give you, in this website, mention who to write. 2 minute letter by email. 2 minute letter, email. Send it on the computer, email. Will be enough. Speak as a parent, as a father, as a mother, as a child, as a child, as a Muslim, as a Christian. This is wrong to destroy the morality of our small innocent children. So please write it down. www.safeonline.org. Simple. Safe online, one word. Safe online. All together. One word. .org.uk. Please write it down. And tonight or tomorrow. If you have time, answer the consultation or inside email, you write to the government. Few line. The more letter, the more email they see, they will listen to you. This is one of the beauty living in Britain, in the West, or in Europe. The more public say no, no to sex film on the internet, on the computer, our children, no, 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 the more letter, they will stop. They listen to you. The Prime Minister listen to you. Your Member of Parliament listen to you. And by the way, another way to write to Member of Parliament, to ask him, to ask her, to stop this filth, this immorality, this haram, this zina. As you know, Prophet Muhammad SAW said, I commit adultery. Zina too. I commit adultery. So I repeat, www.safeonline.org.uk. Safeonline.org.uk. Very easy. You go through it, and my Christian friend made this website for this issue. And they put guidance to you what to say, the best way to say in every answer. So if you're going to answer consultation, try to answer question 10, please. The most important from all. Or 2-3 line letter by email, the email address to the government there. Parental Internet Control Consultation at educationgsi.gov.uk. Even you can send letter by post, there is address if you want. You haven't got computer or internet, you know. So parental internet controls consultation all together, one word. Parental internet control consultation at education.gsi.gov G for George, .gov.uk. It's all inside the website. This is the first duty, you Muslim father and mother, to protect your children here in Britain. Any Muslim listening in other country, you have to start a new campaign. Should be done in every country, in the East, in the West. Collect yourself together, Muslim, Christian, parent, caring about their children, and make campaign and petition and letter and protest and picketing. Stop the filth in our children's computer. All pornography and sexual filth. Now, my second action to you, Islam and current issue. This is the title. Another current issue I've been busy with it. Very important and relevant to doctor, Muslim doctor and other. We have part of Britain called Wales. We have Scotland, we have England, we have Wales, we have Northern Ireland, all called Britain or United Kingdom. We have. So there will be, there is a new consultation in Wales, but any person in Britain can answer the consultation. Again, I say, this consultation, question, answer, question, it may be difficult for many Muslims. The other way, 2-3-line letter by email or by post. The address is in the consultation. What about called presumed or deemed consent? What does it mean? Mean when mommy die, daddy die, any Muslim die or non-Muslim, the government by law, by force, take the organ of my father when he died. Take the organ of my mother when she died. By force, by law. So we want to stop it. We always say, keep the law as it is. Anybody interested to give organ donation, can do it. Fill a form, register, fill a card. But by law, by force. Obviously, they say, except if you write in your life, will, or register, don't take my organ. But most people are not aware. And almost all Muslims are not aware of this way to go around, where to get form, you know, and to fill it and say, don't take my organ, etc. By the way, it's good to remember when you make your will. Will is sunnah, important in Islam. It's good to add at the bottom, please do not take my organ after I die. You know, obviously some other Muslims believe in organ donation, etc. I'm not disputing that. We are objecting. And who's leading the campaign again? Christian. Good Christian. People of the book, British. And I'm helping, joining them. We're doing a big campaign now in Cardiff, in Wales, the center of the consultation. So again, we want to say no. This is not democratic. This has no human right to anybody, and a lot of people, they don't feel in their life or make their will, don't take my organ. Keep the law as it is. So please, my dear brother, we have got till, brother and sister, we have got till 10 September. Your daughter, your son who knows better English can do it for you, 2-3 lines. Speak as a parent, as a human being, as a Muslim, you know, whatever you want to say, the reason or without, say we object. Keep the law as it is. Anybody interested to give organ, he, she can go and fill a form. But suddenly, I am distressed. My mother died. I see this doctor stealing the liver, the heart, the organ of my mother, my father. Without the mother's permission, without the father's permission, without the relative permission. This is unbelievable. It's becoming like jungle in the name of organ transplantation. Jungle. By force. You have to speak up. You have to protect. You know, our organs are holy in Islam. And over the subject of organ transplantation is a big subject. We are not discussing it. I know a lot of Muslims agree with it, but there are six, seven strict conditions. Many Muslims forget that. If you give your organ during your life, you know. And some Muslim minority, you know, ulama and scholars say, no, you don't give organ, you don't do organ transplantation. We don't want to discuss that. We want only to emphasize no to forced taking of my organ, my mom organ, my dad's organ. No way. If I gave permission in my life, it's a different story. No, because as I always say, not only Muslim, non-Muslim, they don't think of death. Everybody thinks death later. Many of us, let's face it. So they don't go and feel, and a lot of Muslim and non-Muslim suddenly die. Young, middle age, disaster, car accident, earthquake, flood. You know, we have so many. We don't think to go and fill a form. Do not take my organ, so please. We want to keep the law as it is. And no, they call it presumed consent. Means they expect that you agreed to give the organ. Rubbish. I never gave permission. I never filled the form. And my family cannot have no role, cannot overrule, cannot stop it. Presumed consent or deemed consent. Write to me. Write the email address. I'm trying to make it easy for you without you going to the consultation, etc. And we have a big address in Cardiff, in Wales, where to send it. But I'm sure today computer and internet so common today everywhere. Please write it down. I'm giving you just one line, half a line. To write 2-3 lines. We don't agree with your new proposal, new bill, presumed or deemed consent. We don't agree. Keep the law as it is. Anybody interested to donate, he or she will go and fill a form or card. Write it down, please. Organ donation. One word together. Organ donation. At Wales, Wales, .gsi. G for George, gsi.gov, mean government, G-O-V, G for George, .uk. This is important for British Muslim, Somali, Pakistani, Arab, Bangladeshi, English convert. You are watching in Britain and listening. I'm asking you for 2-minute job to protect the holy organ of your mom and dad and you and your family and your wife and your children when they die according to the timing fixed by Allah Almighty. So I repeat, organ donation at Wales, W-A-L-E-S dot G-S-I dot gov, G-O-V dot UK. I hope you got it. And start 2-minute job. 2 lines. Put name and address. They will count it. You know, your family can make 7, 10. The wife write one. The son write one. Uncle, cousin, neighbor. Mention the idea in the mosque. Friday prayer. This is what we're trying to do now. Informing mosque. And we have form to sign. Each one, just sign. Sign, sign. Address to the department of health or the organ donation team in Cardiff in Wales. Very easy job, my dear brothers and sisters. I repeat it for the last time now. Organ donation. Organ donation at wales.gsi.gov.uk. gsi.gov.uk. Obviously, anybody want detail can go to the Google search consultation on organ donation in Wales. You will get all detail if you have got time to go show it all today. So this is 2 action, 2 current issues related to British Muslim. Funny enough, it's not only Muslim. I said before, those taking the lead are English, Scottish, Welsh, Christian, non-Muslim. And we share with them. By the way, I'm discovering day after day, we share a lot with the good practicing Christian. We share a lot. Many people, many Muslim and Christian, they don't know that. We share a lot. Maybe one day we'll discuss it, inshallah, in detail. And this is great for da'wah and holy alliance and working together on a lot of issues. Pro-life, sanctity of life, no abortion, no euthanasia. Family, marriage, chastity, motherhood, you know, morality. So many things we share. There are many organizations, Christian, active now. But I don't see Muslim and mosque active or aware or doing something or shaking hand with the other non-Muslim, with the Christian. This is Islamic principle to work and join together. You know, like Hilf al-Fudul at time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a 21st century new Hilf al-Fudul. Subhanallah. Now I finish my two action. In fact, there are two other action. I don't think we will have time to go through it. And this not limited to time, to week. There have been two programs, Channel 4 last week, last Monday, 1.5 hours. Islam, the untold story. Horrible. Full, putting question mark on the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On presence of Mecca, they say all fictitious, all made, all myth. And many Muslims upset, they send letter complaint, like 600 now, you know, to you can complain to channel4.com/complain, and this is the way Muslims should do. Another program, Citizen UK, it was traditional Pakistani family, I think, Muslim, comedy. It irritates a lot of Muslims, making fun, ridicule of Islam, indirectly of Quran, of mosque, of Salat, 30 minutes. And I think maybe they're repeating it also. They have 6, they done 1, and another 1 this week. Again, you have to complain also to Ofcom, the body regulate television in Britain, ofcom.org.uk, and to complain to Channel 4. This is 2 issues, irritating, annoying the Muslim. The clever one, 2-line email. Complain to register your complaint, and when they see a lot, they will stop the program. As simple as that. Now, allow me to go to the common way which I like to present. As I told you, I have about 15 new scientific, medical issue, social issue relevant to Islam and Muslim, which came recently. Now, the first one, if I can mention it, a medical study on the Independent newspaper, 26 August, a light drink, little drink of alcohol, can cause cancer. Cancer in your body, by the way, alcohol, haram, khamr, haram. Today, medically, we discover why it's haram. We have got like 50 disease coming from drinking alcohol. Now, this interesting study, they say a little bit, because some people argue with you, I don't get drunk, I only drink a little bit. A little bit, light drink, cancer, many cancer. By the way, alcohol by itself generally causes about 10 type of cancer in the human body. And why I brought this issue? Because it's so interesting. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith before, "Ma askara kathiruhu faqaliluhu haram." What make you drunk in a big quantity, a little bit of it is haram. Look at that, so beautiful. Like the study just came last week. A little bit will cause cancer, not drinking daily a lot of alcohol, a little bit, subhanallah. As a prophet, he's putting medical and disease second. He always, as you know, in Islam, haram, halal, sinful or not. This is a big thing in Islam, but subhanallah, we discover anything haram, if you do it, you have disease. Anything halal, if you do it, you will have health. Fascinating. Muslim doctor all over the world discovering day after day about this beauty of Islam that is shifa. This another thing will go under my theory of talk to you every week, every Monday, inshallah, 3 o'clock. You know, shifa, a lot of things we discover show that Quran is shifa, cure, treatment, medicine, subhanallah. Next, this is important now to the man. This came only a few days ago. BBC News, 27 August. Very relevant to the man, to boy, Muslim man, Muslim boy. What is it about? Urination, you know urination. Forgive me, I have to explain it. Passing water, wee-wee, going to the toilet. Minister Stephen Chen, Environmental Protection Administration in Taiwan, you know Taiwan, Southeast Asia, caused a debate, uproar, protest. What did he say? He said, for hygienic reason, man should sit on the toilet to pass water, to do micturition, urination. Wee-wee. For the wee-wee, what? I said, not standing up. And what's the reality today? The reality, most of us, we stand up. Even Muslim parent, father, Muslim boy, stand up, do wee-wee, micturition. Woman, Allah made her physiologically, anatomically, she cannot stand up. She has to sit to pass water. The man, the educated minister in the government, said for hygienic reason, hygiene, cleanliness, subhanallah. Hygienic, they discovered medically, because when you stand up and the urine coming from up, down, it go by force, it goes back on you when it touch the wall of the toilet. And sometimes the urine is on the seat of the toilet. You cannot see. Sometimes the urine is dropping on the floor and you're going by your feet, touching the floor of the toilet. And if you sit on the toilet seat, it comes on your, stick to your skin, in your bum. Urine. Najasa. They're coming to the Prophet advice now. Minister, highly educated, non-Muslim. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never urinate unless he sat down. An-Nisa'i. So many statements. Early Islam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sahaba, Muslim, you don't stand up, man, boy, and pass urine like things coming up, coming down, a show. You sit. They're getting closer to Sunnah now. They're becoming close to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He doesn't know about Sunnah. He doesn't know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked us to do that more than 1400 years ago, before medical study, before evidence on hygiene, health, etc. Ya salam. Ya salam. This is a new medical miracle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I'm bringing this subject because we have a serious problem among our own Muslim community. We have a serious problem. Especially when they have this Western English toilet today, you know, and they stand up, pass urine, etc. Why? And we need to stop it. For hygiene reason, najasa. We need tahara, tuhur. And why I'm bringing it? Because one type of عذاب القبر, suffering in the grave after you die. If you don't care about your urine dropping on your pant, in your knicker, dropping on the floor, etc. Look, Islam, how fussy about hygiene. No najasa, no urine dropping on your knicker, in your pant, on the toilet seat, on the floor. So please make note of that, my dear brother and sister. You, Muslim man, you have to be a model, a teacher to your son, and behave properly when you go to toilet and follow Sunnah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The big minister in Taiwan, and I'm sure a lot of them, but I was surprised they say Japan, 33% of men in Japan and Sweden sit on the toilet seat. They don't stand up to pass water, wee-wee, urination. My dear brother, my dear sister, I only mention one of the 12, 13 new medical study, scientific study, social study. I wish I have time more, you know, and I will try to have a break now. Now, if there is any question or comment in good, slow English or good, slow Arabic, inshallah. Otherwise, I will carry on. Any question, any comment? I'm ready. If there is no question and no comment, let me pick up one or two interesting study came lately also. This was also in Daily Mail, 24 August. Sex education in the last 40 years had no effect on teenage pregnancy. You know, here in Britain, in Europe, in the West, we have rising number of small, younger, pregnant, not married. Free mixing, boyfriend, girlfriend, going together. This is affecting many Muslims, by the way. It's going to many Muslims, Bangladeshi, Somali, Pakistani, copying the non-Muslim. So we have a high rate teenage pregnancy. They are young, 13, 14, 15, girl, daughter in school, pregnant. And you know, last 40 years, there have been a lot of money, a big campaign in Britain, spending to educate about sex. And they done it in the wrong way. They never address the cause. The cause is zina, adultery. They don't want to say stop it. It is in the Ten Commandments, those you shall not commit adultery. They allow it to carry on. They went around it and spent 100 million of our taxpayer money, we Muslim in Britain. And non-Muslim too, the taxpayer. So they announced after 40 years and wasting more than 40 million all this sex education in school, telling them about sex, they failed. And I say it simply and briefly because they did not deal with the cause of problem. As you know, today is halal here in Britain, in France, in Germany, in America. Halal, normal, my son, my daughter, everyone to have boyfriend, girlfriend, and to go out and sleep together. No need for marriage. Zina, adultery, legalized, halal. And you know, if you don't do that here in Britain, in the West, they say, you are abnormal. Question mark. Look, how halal become haram, haram become halal. It's unbelievable. So in the last, you know, 40 years, they confess after wasting thousands of meetings, a million of pounds and money and literature, etc., because they did not address the cause. They did not address the cause. The cause is sleeping around, adultery, fornication. In fact, another thing relevant, only a few days ago came a beautiful study. It was in the Independent yesterday. Study in university saying people who wait to have intimate relation, man and woman, husband and wife, if they wait till marriage, they are happier later and they have longer relationship, man and woman, husband and wife. And you know this problem today, this promiscuity, sexual immorality in Britain, in Europe, in the West, is giving us the government, the budget, the economy, a hell of a problem. They broke the law, the Christian law. Jesus' law, peace be upon him. You shall not commit adultery. It's normal. It's halal to go around and pick up a girl, a woman, etc., boyfriend, girlfriend. This haram starter, adultery, zina, look what it's giving us. Over 500,000 sexually transmitted disease every year. Over 400,000 or 400 cases of abortion every day in Britain. We have 600 every day, two-thirds because of sex, haram, no marriage, friendship, boyfriend, girlfriend, about 25 sexually transmitted disease. 10,000 of teenage mother in school, they are children pregnant with a child. Illegitimate children born, they keep the child, some of them, illegitimate child, no father, no husband, nothing. Subhanallah. So I thought I'd bring your attention. Obviously, Islam has got its own way to give biology about anatomy, pregnancy, procreation, fertilization, beautiful, all in a special way, in a halal way, and in marriage, you know, and Islam is with knowledge, with medical knowledge. In fact, the Holy Book Quran is full of ayat talking about conception, fertilization, implantation, alaq, mudgha, you know, all beautiful. We need education, all of us, men and women, but not this filthy, immoral way of sex education, which is so common today in the West, in school, in Britain, everywhere. My dear Muslim brother and sister, this is what I like it to say today. If there is no question, no answer, and no question, no comment, maybe inshallah we'll finish our program, and I hope to be with you inshallah next Monday at 3 o'clock, if I am alive, 3 o'clock in the afternoon next Monday, to discuss many new relevant important issue, current issue, and show you the beauty of Islam, the mercy of Islam. And this religion is a really true religion. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was really and is the physician and the teacher to mankind sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thank you for watching. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.